Do you think the $13 million tax waiver for the downtown hotel developer is justified, and why?
I hate to say this, but I've actually been told that it's not even going to be a hotel. That there are actually kitchenettes in every unit, and the expectation is that they're going to rent them out to students. I don't know how that's going to impact our hotel tax funds. I don't think that the project is a good project. I don't think that we needed to give them $13 million. I think that it would make actually a great location for student housing, and I'm really disappointed that we haven't done that. The university's increased its allotment of students every year, and they're not providing housing for those people, and so we're now seeing, in our neighborhoods, we're seeing people where they rent out their house and they've got 25, 26, 30 students living in a house. Because they take the living room and they make it a separate room. They take the dining room and they make it a separate room. They take each of the four bedrooms and they make it a separate room. They put one bed against each wall, so you've got four beds in every room. I have been to those houses. I have seen it. I have gotten phone calls from you about how upset you are about this. I can't blame the students. They're just trying to get by. And the greedy speculators who are buying these houses and paying top dollar for them are actually renting out beds in the room. So you don't even get to pick who's going to share that room with you. Four boys in one room, four girls in another room, and one bathroom in the whole house. This is not acceptable. I think that $13 million write-off, because I don't think we're ever going to see that money again, was ridiculous. It's another example of how our current council is captured by developers. Is anybody here heard of Quimby funds? In most of America, you get Quimby funds so that when you build a big atrocity like that, you have to support the community. You have to give money to the community so that we have parks, so we can repair our parks, so we can acquire open space. Berkeley doesn't do that. Why?
$13 million wasn't just some sort of pie-in-the-sky $13 million. That was our money, okay? That was our money, and that was money that should have gone into the city coffers to pay for new parks and full pools and things that we really need in our city desperately. That money could have helped a number of homeless people and maybe have provided permanent housing for some. So that is not money that we should have ever, ever given up. Now there's another very important issue I want to raise, and that was something that Councilmember Wengraf said a few minutes ago. She said she took pride in balancing all these budgets. Well, the fact of the matter is, it's a state law to balance a budget. We have to balance budgets. We don't have a choice but to balance our budgets. We do that in many, many different ways, but we do it mostly by cutting services and also cutting back on maintenance. The maintenance in our city is almost non-existent. And I think all of you probably are here tonight because you have your own story to tell about the lack of maintenance in our cities. So how does the city then deal with that? How does it then ultimately end up balancing the budget? Well, it's actually very simple. It just keeps doing service cuts and those sorts of things. But then also, we have a structural deficit every year. And what that means is that our expenses far exceed our revenues. So for example, next year, we will have a structural deficit of approximately $4.5 million. By 2020, that's going to go up two or three fold. And that is mostly because of the labor contracts that were given last year. We gave extraordinary new labor contracts of approximately $16 million. Thank you.
So I'm going to try to answer the question. The question was, did I support the $13 million, how did you phrase it?
Tax waiver for the downtown hotel.
This is something that I thought about a great deal, and what I realized was that it's very, very important for us to have a new hotel downtown. We do not have enough hotel space in Berkeley. We're losing tremendous amounts of hotel tax to Emory Storyville and Oakland, we only have basically the Shattuck Hotel downtown. And that's it. The Claremont Hotel does not pay taxes to the city of Berkeley. They're in Oakland.
Right.
It's very important for us to have another hotel. This site has been designated for a hotel for years, and several hotel operators came through, and the deal kept falling through. They couldn't make it work. It's a very constricted site. It's not easy to develop a hotel on this site. In order for them to leverage the funds that they needed to move forward with this project, we needed to forgive the $13 million fee. It's not money taken out of the general fund and given to them. We will get this money back probably in 4 years and more if this hotel gets built. The reason why this hotel has kitchens is because it's an extended stay hotel. They've done their market research and they have decided that an extended stay hotel, like they have in Emeryville, is what Berkeley needs here. Regardless of who occupies those rooms, they will have to pay a hotel tax. So I think it's a good thing. I'm very optimistic. I really hope it happens. That Bank of America corner is really, really needs to be upgraded. We really need a hotel, and it will bring all kinds of ancillary revenue to the city as well.
Since it takes at least 5 votes to get any